I'm Richard L. Seeley, an engineer by profession and former Minister of Tourism and International Transport. But more importantly, a Barbadian who has proudly represented the good people of St. Michael South Central for 15 years. During that period of time, the people of St. Michael South Central became more than constituents. They became family. From the elderly women who were like mothers to me, to my many godchildren who are like my own children, I love the people of St. Michael South Central. And I have no doubt that they in turn love me. I accepted the result of the 2018 general election and saw it as an opportunity to step back, reflect, and re-energize for a new season of representation. And now I'm here again because I know in my heart I can offer the people of St. Michael South Central the quality representation that they deserve. Over the years, with the people of this constituency, I was able to achieve a number of things. Through the Help Them Learn Foundation, we were able to help many students from primary to tertiary in terms of achieving their goals and their dreams. With the Constituency Council, when that existed, we were able to have numerous, hundreds of community development projects, and even without the Constituency Council, we did many things to impact our seniors, our youngsters, sporting events, other community development projects, efforts to assist our seniors, and I'm very proud of that. We also were able to get the Stuart's Lodge housing project in Tweedside Road going. And quite significantly, in my backdrop, you see the Valerie housing project as well in Britain's Hill. 80 families were provided with housing solutions. A good place to raise families. Among many, many, many other projects, we also were able to provide employment opportunities. I know that together with my constituents, we can achieve great things. This election is about people. It's about our children, our families. It's about our senior citizens and our community. This election, certainly for me, is about the people in St. Michael South Central. So on January 19th, I'm asking them for their vote because I know that they deserve better. And I will give them better.
Somebody say fire, fire, fire. Oh. God's Holy Ghost fire deep down. Somebody set fire, 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 yeah. Fire to rebuke Satan in Jesus' name. If you know that he is a jealous God, and we should serve no one else but him, help me sing. Somebody say fire, fire, fire.
Good evening, St. Michael's South Central. Who would have thought that at the beginning of 2022 that we would be in the midst of an election, right in the middle of a pandemic, furthermore. But here we are, and as the Democratic Labour Party, we are ready to offer you our representation. It is no secret to the people of St. Michael's South Central that Richard L. Seeley has been a strong representative for his constituency. With his work in housing and sports and youth empowerment programs, he has continued to show his undying support for your community, and this election is no different. Let's not pretend that last election did not happen, though. The reality is that Barbados came out in their numbers and they voted for what they felt was right. But at this point, we have to vote in favor of our own interests. We often hear the phrase, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. But I implore you, as St. Michael's South Central, not just St. Michael's South Central, but the entire country of Barbados, vote for a representative who can serve you the right way. This is your opportunity to be a bit selfish and choose what is right for you, your family, and your communities at large. And it is with no doubt that I proudly stand here this evening and advocate and endorse the candidate for St. Michael's South Central, Mr. Richard L. Seeley. Throughout his years in Parliament, he has proven to you that his dedication to your constituency is undying. But not only that, his successful tenure as the Minister of Tourism is without doubt one of the best that I can speak of. People may have issues with some of his policies and some of his decisions, and let's not lie here. We will have issues with every single representative that will come in the future and every single one that has passed. However, to go on record and say that his track record is not one that is great would be a blatant lie to the rest of our constituents and to the rest of our country mates. Richard Seeley, at the community level, is also very dedicated to diversifying his portfolio. He is dedicated to evolving, and that is what we need because the world has changed, not only with time, as we do expect to happen, but in the midst of a pandemic, the needs of our communities have definitely evolved. And with that, our candidate has also evolved. As such, he will be focusing on the same areas that he has focused on before. So housing will be important. So let's not pretend that we are not young people in this country who need to find more opportunities for housing. The Prime Minister came and promised us that she would be able to give $3,500 for legal fees. And that sounds like a beautiful idea. However, what is the point of you giving me $3,500 for legal fees when I cannot even qualify for a mortgage? And furthermore, the reality is that if I qualify for the mortgage, I am likely to default on it because job opportunities are not out there for those who are either in university educated or not. And in a country like Barbados, we have to ensure that Barbadians, whether they have that education level, are able to excel and not only survive. It is important that we create excellent housing opportunities for low-income families, because those who are not even low-income are struggling. And I'm not sure how we expect to see growth in this country when those at the bottom of the socioeconomic classes are not growing. The reality is that it's hard to even go to the supermarket and pick up a full trolley of groceries for your family. It's hard to pick up a trolley of groceries for yourself. And if we do not create these opportunities for young people, we will see ourselves regressing, because it makes no sense saying that Barbados is doing well when only a certain strata is doing well. At the end of the day, we need to see consecutive planning, we need to see general growth, and we need to see each and every socioeconomic class in our country. We need to see them having opportunities for upward social mobility. And right now, I do not see those things. We continue to talk about entrepreneurship as an opportunity out. But the reality is that it's becoming increasingly difficult in this country for young entrepreneurs to thrive. How am I expected to start a business when there's no provisions for me as a small business to compete with the bigger businesses? Because quite frankly, and I go without any apology saying that the government panders to big business. When we have governments that do not create opportunities for these smaller business to receive tax exclusions and tax cuts, but yet still offer those opportunities to larger multi-billion and million-dollar corporations, how do we really justify that and make it seem as though we really want young people to thrive in this country? Beyond that, the reality is that every young person does not want to be an entrepreneur. And every young person can't be an entrepreneur, because then we're gonna have a whole society of businesses that really don't have supporters and do not have employees. Quite frankly, it's not for everyone either. And everybody does not have to aspire to that. But how are we preparing our young people to go out there into the field of work and actually thrive? This is not me saying that the government has to produce every job for young people. But it is me saying that community programs that offer young people opportunities for growth and for better development are necessary. And Richard L. Seeley is bringing those programs to our young people. And these are things that we need within our communities. If we do not have these, how are we going to genuinely justify our position in government? Moving on, there are opportunities outside of traditional education and traditional careers. And it is necessary that we push young people to do different things. And that is why it's important to push things like art and sports, something that Richard Seeley has proven that he is dedicated to. We need to see sports programs within our communities, because right now in his constituency, there are not enough opportunities for young sportsmen and women to thrive. And quite frankly, we can say that they're being neglected. We need to see young people having opportunities to not just go out there and practice on a team or as a part of a club, but young people need to see that there's a future for them in a career as a sportsman or sportswoman. The same way that cricketers see that future. And we recognize that that had to be fought for, but we are willing to fight for it. And Richard Seeley has that plan to fight for sports to be recognized and for sports to be developed within his community. For young people, we often hear people pushing us towards education. And the truth is that education is an opportunity for great growth. Let's not pretend that people have not been getting themselves out of bad situations or growing socioeconomically because they've gained an education. And that is not the only way. However, it is an opportunity for growth. But how do we expect people to truly grow if in their youth, they're struggling to make it through school? This pandemic has brought a serious shift in the way that we are educated. And this is placing absolutely no blame on any particular person, because the entire world had to adapt. But interacting with teachers and students, it is clear that it is undeniably difficult to successfully complete a curriculum, because children are sometimes not understanding. It is hard to participate in different learning styles, because there are some children that really do need to physically participate in activities in order to understand. There's some children that are just not understanding their curriculum, and they're slipping through the cracks. And unfortunately, the cracks were small before, but the cracks have turned into craters. Then there are children who just are not making it to school because some of them have unstable Wi-Fi connections. Some of them are in households that are not conducive to their learning. And the reality is that we need to look into methods to ensure that these children do not fall behind. Because how are we going to justify a child at 6, 7, 8 not getting those key foundational educational tools? How are they expected to pass an 11 plus? Or furthermore, how are they expected to pass CSEC level, which is basically the minimum in order to survive in this society? And it is necessary that we enforce programs that will focus on these young people. And in his manifesto, he has plans to ensure that young people have creative ways of learning. Because it's not just about going to school and coming home, or as we are doing right now, logging on and logging off. It is about ensuring that every single child has the tools necessary to be able to survive. And at the community level, we need to provide those things. It is not just the Ministry of Education, because it's not working that way. And as such, your future representative has come up with a plan to ensure that your children are ready to handle the things that the world is going to throw at them. It is with that that I implore you, St. Michael South Central, to vote for a man who is ready to serve you. A man who is not here about the fanfare. A man who is not going to abandon you. A man who has proven that he is ready to serve, and who has proven that he will serve you as a constituency. I am imploring you to put your ex next to a candidate that is not necessarily blatantly BLP or DLP. Yes, he's on the DLP ticket, but this is not what this is about. This is about your candidate. This is about you. And this is about being selfish with your vote, because you have to vote for a man who will serve you, and serve you passionately, and serve you undeniably. A man that will continue to serve you no matter what happens, and will go up against whoever stands in his way in order to ensure that you have what you need to be able to survive. I am imploring you to vote for Richard L. Seeley come January 19th from 6 a.m. until 6 p.m. You have your opportunity to make your voice heard. And I implore you to not only vote for him, but support him throughout his campaign, and ensure that you give him feedback as he is your representative. Make sure that you are holding him accountable to the things that he has promised, because I know that he wants to deliver. But you also have that opportunity to hold him accountable. This is for you. And I am supporting you, and I am supporting your candidate and future representative, Mr. Richard L. Seeley. God bless.
I worship you. I worship you. You are here. You're turning lives around. And I worship you. I worship you. And I say you're waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are the way, the truth and the life,
promise keeper,
light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here. I worship you, Lord, I worship you. You are here, and you're mending every single heart. See, I worship you, Lord, I worship you. You're working, and even when I can't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working, and even when I don't feel it, it's working.
Higher, move thee. For the Lord knows I can't live on the mountain. Oh no, though he picked out a valley for me. Whoa, 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 whoa. Jesus needs me beside still water. Yeah, it was somewhere in the valley below. Question why must it be? For the Lord knows there is strength in your sorrow. Ooh. And there is victory.
First, I want to thank my mom and my family, my wife, my son. It is because of them that I'm able to be here, and it is an honor to stand as the candidate for the constituency of St. James South. And come January the 19th, the representative for the people of St. James South. Over the past 6 months, since I was officially declared the candidate, I've been working in the constituency, and I want to thank the residents and constituents of St. James South for the support they've given me, for letting me into their homes and their hearts, for giving me Christmas decorations, conkeys, advice, tips, drinks, and the hugs that we could not share because of COVID. It has been my honor. I want to be their representative, your representative, for one very, very simple reason. I love our country and I love its people. I see great things for its future. I want the political institution that I am part of, the Democratic Labour Party, I want it to serve the country that I love. Gone will be the days when the conversations will be about people's personalities. These are days to talk about policy, 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 and how we can get things done. It is that simple. It is about substance and not sound bites. And in Richard, I know you will have a candidate, you will have a person who is about substance. That is the sort of candidate that Barbados needs, so that Barbados can be its best, so that we can walk in the sun again. But to get there, we need change. The future is not made in the past. But I don't have to tell you that. You can vote for the future. I ask you to vote not only for myself, I ask you to vote for Richard. Vote for a chance to walk in the sunshine again. Vote for change. It's kind of funny when you think about the fact that I'm not the Member of Parliament currently for the constituency of St. James South, yet I have a record that I can be proud of what I've managed to achieve in the last 12 months, in some instances, in the last 6 months in this constituency. We have facilitated, implemented, executed. We have got it done. From free Wi-Fi for children, allowing them to return to school virtually. But what substantial things has the current Member of Parliament for St. James South achieved, but now wants to talk about bridging the digital divide? How? What does she think that the free Wi-Fi and tablet project that we helped to implement into Haynesville represented? I am super proud of that project, the work that my team did to bring it to life. We facilitated this project, building on the existing homework program, because it is not about doing things to put your name on it. You find programs, you find people in communities, you work with them to enhance what they want, what they've been doing, because it is about empowering them, it is about empowering them and adding value to their work. That is what a Democratic Labour Party government will be about. Because it is not about us, it is about you. It is about getting it done for you. And Richard believes this too, for the people of St. Michael's South Central. In my own constituency, we've supported social welfare programs, Christmas support program, employment facilitation, assistance with the maintenance of a green space. And we had plans for an educational screening program, but we're now in the midst of an election campaign. Tonight, this evening, every night, we are, Richard is not about cursing anybody, making silly points. That's the kind of politics that turns us off. It turns you off. What we are about is substance. This election, 3 years after the last one, is now wide open. But we will not win if we don't have a plan. And we have a plan. We have a clear purpose. The only reason the legacy that the Barbados Labour Party wants another term is for that simple reason. What are their plans? What is the policy? Let us unpack the current work of this government. Even the most strident supporters of Mayor Motley, ardent, passionate supporters, would admit that Mayor Motley is all about sound, little substance. I often find myself unpacking Mayor Motley's speeches and work, not because of the delivery is not excellent, but because it must take a special kind of personality to live in such glorious contradiction. The cognitive dissonance is real. I guess that's what happens after you've been practicing old politics for so long. But we are about new politics because this is about you. It is about doing a job for you. Now, if I had to ask, this is the same Prime Minister, the same Mayor Motley, who ignored a whole country in determining the form of the republic that we were supposed to come. This is the same Mayor Motley under whose watch cruise ships anchored during COVID, destroying our reefs. This is the same Mayor Motley that blames water management on climate change when research clearly shows that it is poor management of our water resources. This is the same Mayor Motley who kicks the can down the road on everything from governance reform, education reform, economic reform, healthcare reform, every single form of reform. And at first glance, you might think the government's restructuring of the debt was something astronomical. No, we have public debt of over $12 billion. When many of these loans become due, none of the current consultants and the ministers will be around. It will be us, it will be you, your children, your grandchildren, who will have to clean up this current mess. And it will even be worse if we continue with the spending habits of the government. Will this government be remembered for taking away land in Lancaster, already promised to people who attended the Lancaster Housing Fair, and would have started their dream of owning their own homes and getting their own mortgages? and then giving that land to a private company, Hope, and then the Minister of Housing, a former minister, soon to be former minister, had the audacity to defend it. Perhaps Mayor Motley and the government will be remembered for not implementing anti-corruption legislation and what appeared as self-sabotage in the final hurdle to update the anti-corruption laws on our books. We are working harder for less these days. We pay more taxes for less. The cost of living keeps rising. What is the role of government? People have no jobs. They cannot feed their families, pay their rent, buy school uniforms. Where are the new ideas of what government is for? Perhaps this government will be remembered for winning all the seats and creating a brand of politics that feeds party elites and consultants at the top while the rest of us suffer. Yet with all the blunders and bleeps after blunders, Mayor Motley's legacy may be one of disappointment. ID cards, not done. Schools, not reopened. Education reform, not reform. Economic diversification, not happening. Governance reform, none. Jobs, none. But let me tell you how we can get this done. Economic reform, service zones, to facilitate investment locally, internationally, and from our diaspora. Kickstarting the Barbados economy will require large capital injections, with public revenues alone can never achieve, because we face a shrinking revenue base, ravaged by job losses, business closures, and a growing informal economy. Heavy borrowing is also unsustainable for our country. Every single dollar the government pays out in debt servicing is money that cannot be spent on you. It is money that cannot be spent on education, health, roads, social and elderly care. What am I suggesting? I'm suggesting special service zones that exist throughout the world, particularly in Southeast Asia and China. They're subject to more economically liberal laws and regulations, and they can be used to attract foreign direct investment, which can boost employment and provide jobs for you. These new zones can go beyond the traditional low-value, low-paid jobs, which were often exploitative, where we just use low-wage labor in factories to assemble products or call centers. Today's new zones, service zones, can add value to the Barbados economy. They can add value to your life. And we can attract domestic, foreign, and investment from the diaspora in these areas. It doesn't have to be limited to high technology manufacturing. There's medical cannabis, creative industries, renewable energy, fintech, software design, law and arbitration services. But we must be careful about how we develop the Barbados economy, because it must be an economy that serves all of us, one Barbados. We must create wealth for our people and empower them so that they can provide for their families. Barbadians must have opportunities in the new Barbados economy. So any new project must be rooted in that principle. It must contribute to the social development of Barbados. For example, to underwrite the economic development for things such as health, education, and elderly care. Any new development must contribute to the infrastructure of Barbados so that surrounding communities of new projects can have community centers, parks, schools, and roads upgraded. Any new economic development must provide for the enfranchisement of Barbadians. For example, it's not simply about providing jobs. Barbadians must have opportunities, real chances to grow businesses, to create businesses, and to create their own wealth. Any new economic development must provide for wealth creation opportunities for Barbadians through procurement of goods and services. So basically, the government can use its capacity in terms of buying things to help grow businesses, and not just one or two select businesses, but businesses for all Barbadians. Now, the creation of these service zones can also encapsulate the University of the West Indies as its core, which borders my constituency. And we must explore the fact of how we can make Cave Hill the equivalent of our Silicon Valley in Barbados. We can do these things. We can provide the jobs for you and your families so that you are empowered and not waiting on handouts. It's about a hand up. This is what new politics is about. It's about empowering you to be the best of yourself. We are on your side. Richard is on your side. The Democratic Labour Party is on your side. I, Ronnie Yearwood, am on your side. We have to let optimism win the day. New ideas, new people. Let us walk in the sun together. The Democratic Labour Party is ready. We are ready to serve you. We are ready to fight for you and for your issues. We are ready to be the change that you want. We are ready for victory on Election Day, 19th of January. Go out and vote for Richard Seeley. Ask your family and your friends to vote for the DLP candidate in your area. We can get this done. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Take it to the Lord in prayer. Go out and vote, Barbadians.
My load gets lighter, walking up the King's Highway. There is joy in knowing where I am going, walking up the King's Highway. Hurry, I don't have to worry, walking up the King's Highway. Angels there to guide me, Jesus there to love me, walking up the King's Highway.
Walking up the King's Highway.
I gave him my right hand, and as soon as ever my back was turned, he scandalized in my name. Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
He scandalized in my name. Well, I met a sister the other day. I gave her my right hand, and as soon as ever my back was turned, she scandalized in my name. Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no. Candlelight in my name.
Well, I met a preacher the other day. I gave him my right hand, and as soon as ever my back was turned, he scandalized in my name. Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion? Oh, scandalize him, I
listen.
Well, I met my cousin the other day. I gave him my right hand, and as soon as ever my back was turned, he scandalized him, my name. Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Oh, scandalize him, my name. Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Do you call that religion?
No, no.
Oh, scandalize in my name.
Hey, hey, here we go.
This train is a holy train.
This train.
My Lord, my God. This train is a holy train.
This train.
My Lord, my God. This train is a holy train.
everybody write it in Jesus' name.
This train, this train,
hey! This train, it is bound for glory.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train, it is bound for glory.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train, it is bound for glory. It don't carry nothing but the pure and the holy.
This train, this train.
This train, it don't carry backsliders.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train, it don't carry backsliders.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train, it don't carry backsliders. No motor creepers, no midnight ramblers.
This train, this train,
hey! This train, it don't carry no jokers.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train, it don't carry no jokers. No drinkers, no cigarette smokers.
This train, this train,
hey! This train is a holy train.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train is a holy train.
This train,
my Lord, my God. This train is a holy train. Everybody write it in Jesus' name.
This train, this train, this train.
Good evening to everyone. Indeed, I've invited a few friends to share some music ministry with you so that I can discuss a few issues with you. I'm speaking especially to those persons in the St. Michael's South Central constituency that I will be contesting in the upcoming general election, but indeed speaking to those who may not reside in the constituency as well, because I have a number of concerns that I think need to be aired and given some attention to. Now, again, we have a number of values that this country has been built on. And what we have seen happening recently is that our values have been under attack. The difference between right and wrong, the quickness to resort to violence among our young people, even in the school environment, and of course, a general acceptance for behavior that we don't necessarily accord with our norms. So I think going into this general election, it's important that we anchor ourselves in what we consider to be influencing behavior and influencing attitudes. And so I make no apologies for perhaps taking a non-traditional approach in seeking the favor of the residents of St. Michael's South Central, because we have seen this happening over a period of time, and we have to start to ask ourselves what is influencing this trend and whether there's anything that leaders can do about it. I believe that we have to, at the very least, set standards and provide an example that can show that we're interested in taking our country forward. And yes, old influencers and new influencers need to be brought on board so we can discuss what is fueling this general trend with respect to the so-called modern values and whether or not we can still maintain what we may consider to be traditional. It's no point speaking to yourself and expect that we can transform these realities. We have to speak to everyone. We have to forge a national identity that is not laying blame on anyone or any entity, but we have to look at the man or the woman in the mirror and start to see what we can do to improve that situation. We have to come up with workable programs that will see our young people especially, but indeed all of those who may be on the margin, given a more meaningful place in our society. I believe that it is necessary, now more than ever, that we establish some sort of arrangement, a pilot project, not necessarily a government project, but a national project that can look at these efforts or can be aimed at simply addressing these concerns. Remember, the pandemic, unfortunately, has virtually completely wrecked what we would have called a school environment, and it looks like if that is going to be a reality for some time to come. And so we have to figure out other ways that we can influence our young minds. We are in a situation where, unfortunately, community leadership is at an all-time low. We are bereft of that phenomenon, and we therefore have to moderate a national discourse to get us through this current plight. And we are talking about a time where there's alienation and detachment, and that's rampant in our country, and a feeling that there's one law for the Medes and one law for the Persians. In other words, those that have are held to a different standard to those that don't have. And this brings us to the issue of the government of the day. Because while I am prepared to recognize that these are national phenomena that have been with us for a while, I also believe that the behavior of this government has done nothing to address these fundamental issues. The whimsical application of the curfew, the arrest, charging, and incarceration of ordinary Barbadians while big and wealthy get a mild slap on the wrist is again two laws and a different standard. The lockdown that saw us being told to go to the big business supermarket, big business, to get our produce and our provisions and so on, while small operators were shut down and were told they could not open. You know, the general trend here, if you understand where I'm going, again, is this national double standard of this government. And it is clear to all, whether you are a proponent of this government or an opponent of this government, whether you are a beneficiary of this government or a victim of this government, whether you are with them or whether you are against them, all Barbadians have it clear in their mind whose interests they're serving. And in my opinion, that is not good for the nation. The national interest, it has become secondary to party interests, to the interests of the political leader, and to the interests of the political organization we know as the Barbados Labour Party. And that's a dangerous place to be. We all know everyone was concerned about allegations of despotism. And I was probably among those who felt that that was a little extreme. But any doubts I had, if I had a scintilla of doubt, it was removed on the 27th day of December 2021. Days after Christmas, the ham hadn't even been put up yet. Christmas cake crumbs were still on the table. People still had sorrel in their fridge. The Prime Minister races up to Government House and dissolves Parliament to facilitate a general election in the midst of a terrible pandemic. A pandemic which, according to her, was not the place to have a general election campaign. What changed? Her interests ahead of the national interests. Again, one law for those that have, and one law for those that don't have. We need to move away from that kind of thinking. We need to put Barbados first. And indeed, I maintain that that also calls for a look at our values. And those of us who see this kind of
intolerant and lack of inclusiveness on the part of our political leadership are the ones who I think are a little fed up working so hard, the salt of the earth Barbadians, and they think that we can do better, and I agree that we can do better, and I'm prepared to be part of that effort to change this kind of behavior. And I want to say that, yes, I am a Christian, and I'm very comfortable in this environment with my fellow Christians, but I understand tolerance of all religious persuasions, but I will not accept that we need to denigrate those traditional Christian values that have served this country well, allowed us to punch above our weight and to be such a phenomenal small island developing state. And I therefore humbly submit that we need to keep that in mind as we build out and move on as a society and as a country. I'm convinced that if we make the right decision on the 19th of January, we will be able to have these issues brought to the fore in the governance process. And in doing that, we can then address some of the other matters. Because once you have the right set of core values, you are then able, naturally, to manage your health system, manage your education system, manage the economy, manage the social care sector. All of those elements will follow, but something has to undergird it all. And something has gone wrong in Barbados at that deep fundamental level. And I therefore want to urge all of you to come out in your numbers on the 19th of January and support the Democratic Labour Party. Special word to those in my riding, St. Michael's South Central. You would have noticed over the last 3 years, almost every single program that was aimed at improving the quality of life of the average constituent is under threat or has been totally eliminated. We have to fix that. And it starts by bringing Richard Seeley back as your representative in St. Michael's South Central. And I'm not going to rest there. I have promised all of the residents that coming back as a new and improved product, that we can then take these initiatives to another level. The Help Them Learn Foundation, all of the effort with our students, the various work with the sporting organizations, teaming up with any meaningful community development initiative and seeking sponsorship and having these things become a reality. Working with primary school students to, among other things, deal with conflict resolution. I enjoyed my tenure as the representative of St. Michael's South Central, and I look forward to this second innings with a view of addressing some of these things at another level. I would concede that I learned a lot, and maybe I didn't have the same mental frame of reference that I have now. But as I have said earlier, I have improved. And I want to thank all of you, especially who have offered prayers, who have interceded with the Almighty on my behalf. And I assure you that I myself, every morning when I'm on my knees praying and asking God to use me for His work, that I will do so aware of these very lofty standards that I have set. I just think it's important that the business of representation be taken to another level. And I will also say that my work in the rest of Barbados and standing up for what is right, for trying to create a more just society, that work will also be given in a fresher, newer, and more energetic drive.
I look forward to continuing to work with you. And I want to, again, thank you for all of the wonderful support you have offered. I would, at this stage, only say that we need all Barbadians to pull in a common direction. And be aware that supporting Richard Seeley means, again, no special provision for friends and family. No double standard in how policy is to be implemented. But we're going to operate on a basis where all Barbadians, irrespective of your religious persuasion, irrespective of your sexual orientation, your race, your age, your gender, all of you will be able to find a place in this society that you can advance, that you can enjoy a quality of life, and that we can all help rebuild this wonderful country and once again make it a land that the envy of the entire world. Once again, thank you for sharing in this event. Please enjoy the quality music ministry. Thank you all for making this possible. And I wish you every blessing for 2022. And I also encourage you to stay safe as we go through this pandemic. Thank you very much.
Who's marching with me? We're marching to Zion. Ah, yeah. Marching on in the light of God. Marching on, I am marching on. Up the path that the Master trod. Marching, marching on.
Walk holy, God is holy. Oh, Zion's
St. Michael's South Central, this election, it's about you. This election is about you, the people. It's about your children, it's about your family, it's about your future. The high cost of living continues to strangle Barbadians. There's a serious lack of opportunity for our young people, and our seniors are finding it hard to make ends meet. We can do better. You deserve better. Join me, Richard L. Seeley, on this campaign because it's about you.